Sometimes we're looking for the more, but we just don't know what the more is. And then we come to play with me. Three words that mean play, toys, fun, games, cheekiness, with, intimacy, connection, relationships, and finally me. It starts with self, and that is something that Play With Me stands for. Play With Me is a place where you have an experience of all of those things. One complete cycle. You're welcome to pop in at our shop at the gantry in Four Ways, or find us at www.playwithme.co.za. If you're looking for that more, please get in touch.
Do something different this Valentine's month. Join us for a beautiful, fun, and deeply nourishing sacred intimacy couples retreat on the South Coast, KZN. From the 23rd to the 25th of February, wake to the sound of the sea, renew your connection, relax in bliss body massage, and reconnect with your love. Go to www.blissandrelaxation.com for more info.
The views and opinions expressed in this program are those of the speakers and do not necessarily reflect the views or positions of any entities they represent or that of the program, its presenters, hosts, directors, or other team members.
This show is intended for audiences aged 23 and older. This production and its digital copies contain content of an adult nature. If you are easily offended or are under the age of 18, this show is not intended for you. The posts, pages, and recordings within are intended for adults only and may include descriptions of scenes of sexual content, suggestive opinions, detailed discussions, and graphic topics. Listener discretion is advised. For Kinky Classes with your hosts, Lady Lola and Ms Kitten. Come on in and take your seats. Tonight's class is about to start.
Good evening, Lustfuls, and welcome to class number 5 of the first semester in Kinky Classes. And yes, guys, Lola is still fucking sick. I did another COVID test, and it seems like your girl Lola has the vova. Got a little bit of COVID. It's okay. We'll survive, right? We'll survive. Very excited for tonight's class. I mean, I was asleep until 8 o'clock, and I had to wake up in the tiz because we're doing live Spanks, and that's a good time. I'm all about having a good time, and we all know that, right? So, let me start off by mentioning the endorsement site. Lola's favorite friends at the Council of Fantasy. The COF is a lifestyle-orientated community that is driven by sex positivity. We have a WhatsApp community. You guys can join the WhatsApp community on the Lola's website. That is www.lola'sfm. That's lust, basically, with two L's. So it's www.lola'sfm.live. So go to the website, go and click on the WhatsApp link, come and join us, come and have some fun with us on the CAF. We have a ball, guys. If you aren't there, have you even been living, right? Your Lola Blakely production moderators for this evening are Azure Inferno. She'll be moderating and doing your obscene disclaimer. It is Black Dragon posting the welcoming messages to all the new live listeners and general moderating. We have Zane with us. Zane will be your conversation starter during the break. He's really good at that. I like the way he starts conversation and getting our listeners to ask questions, and he'll be keeping the chat on Podbean app to topic. And then KB, our production manager for this evening, posting your socials and updating the list of moderators for this evening. So if you see them in the chat, say hi, guys. They're here to engage with our listeners. They're here to keep us safe during the airing. Feel free to ask them any questions or send them a wave. Remember to like and follow the show. If it's your first time joining us, we have so much fun here, guys, even when Lola's sick. And then let's not forget, my gorgeous, let me just go back to the video chat, because now the video chat's gone because I was reading off of my phone, which I'm not supposed to be doing. There we go. Turning my phone. Oh, she's flashing me boobs already. Tonight's going to be a good time. I can just see the shit's going to be a good time. Let's go to my gorgeous co-host, Ms Kitten. Hello, Ms Kitten.
Hello.
Oh, you sound very far. We're doing Spanks, so her mic is not properly positioned. That's what I'm looking for.
Is that
for.
Better? Can you hear me now?
Pardon. Sorry, I just choked on my water.
No, I'm that surprising. I have that effect on a lot of people. It's so good to be back, and it's so good to be with you. I'm so excited tonight, though, because I'm at the Playbox Dungeon, and I am sitting in the Playbox Dungeon with Mother Russia, the owner of the Playbox, and she's going to spank my bum for me tonight, so I'm in super excited kitten mode, and I've been waiting for the spanks the whole day. So before we start, I just want to say happy Wellington's Day to everybody.
Right. Will you be my Valentine?
I thought you were mine already.
I've got a problem. Can I tell you why? So I asked KB to be Kinky Bunny to be my Valentine. Then so she said yes, and then she asked me, and I said yes. And then Miss Carmen from Play With Me, she also asked me to be a Valentine, and I also said yes. And now you're also my Valentine. So this is a lot of chocolates that Dona needs to buy this year.
I think that's a great plan. Let's get on it.
We're going to get fat. A lot of us are going to get fat. I just make sure I have a lot of Valentines, because I generally don't have Valentines. So this year I thought I'm doing something different. I want everybody. All the ladies.
I don't do Valentines. I do Single Awareness Day.
Yes, of course.
Single Awareness Day for me and Wellington's Day. So will you be my Wellington?
I will be your Wellington. We can be single Wellingtons together. How's that? Love it. Okay, so let's get started with Mother Russia, right? Mother Russia started her own store, her own online store, to showcase her paddles and impact items locally made. I just took a look at some of these items just before we went on air, right? And Ms Kitten was showing me a couple of them on the video call. And they are absolutely gorgeous. They're really, really well crafted. They're very pretty. Lola loves pretty things, yes? So I absolutely love them. Then to showcase the paddles and impact that's locally made, it's her creative outlet for her to design and develop impact items that she wants to use. Oh, my voice is going. I'm so sorry, listeners. She loves impact play. Mother Russia comes out and she wants to lead you on a journey of pain, laughter, discovery, sensation, and glowing bums. We like glowing bums. That's why we're doing Spanks and Sparkles this evening on Kinky Klasses. Now I can go back to my plain video call with Ms Kitten and Ms Russia. Hello, guys. Why are you guys skew, though? What's going on in this camera?
Being straight is overrated.
Being straight is overrated. Jesus, I've heard it all now. You heard it, yeah. You heard it on Kinky Klasses first, guys. Being straight is overrated. Okay, let's get to you, Mother Russia. Welcome, and thank you for joining us this evening.
Thank you for having me this evening. I'm being really excited the whole day to be online with you.
Oh, you have? Mother Russia, can I just say, Lola loves you. You know this, yes?
Getting them ready for tonight.
Okay, why don't you start off by talking us through what impact means to you?
Well, I think when I started in the kink, I was just so excited about impact play. I just was very moved by it. I didn't realize it would change my life so much. It's moved me in a way because I've become more of a powerful person, and I know what I want out of the play and out of the sessions, that now I can cater a play for someone else and try and give them, take them on their own journey on what spanking and impact play is about, and not just pick up an implement and spank someone. It's a whole journey of textures, sound, environment, emotions, and trust. It's a beautiful journey to have with someone, and I enjoy doing that for somebody, and it gives me a lot of joy to introduce a new toy, try it on them for a flogger, let's say, because sometimes people are so frightened of flogging because of the sound, but when they actually feel it on their body and they feel the flogger and they feel the leather, they're not so frightened anymore. And that's what I love about impact play, is it's always a surprise, and it can be sensual and sexy, and it also can be vicious and hair pulling and erotic.
When you go vicious and hair pulling, I just start to drip. Let's hear from you, Ms Kitten. What does it mean to you?
I love impact play. I love pain, though. I've bottom probably more than I top for impact play. I love having my bum spanked, and then I love having my stinging bum rubbed. It's super sexy. I love having the back of my thighs spanked. I just, it makes me, it transports me to a place that is hard to reach in everyday life. It takes away all the white noise out of my head, and the pain is a complete release for me, and I'm able to be present and I'm able to let go. And pain is super sexy for me, but I get off on pain. Pain is my kryptonite. So I really enjoy it. And having somebody who has skills, I have Mother Russia here tonight, but I have some other good tops that also spank me. It's just a privilege to be able to take that journey with people who know what they're doing, who know how to use the tools. And as much as, you know, a guy can use his fingers well to please a woman, some of these women can use a paddle to please me. Trust me. They are
That's okay.
Yeah, so I love it.
I love it. Okay, so before we start impact play, right, is there anything that the listeners should know about what impact play is, what are these, before they even pick up a paddle, okay, where do they start, what do, how do they prepare themselves, not only physically, but mentally, because, I mean, there's been a lot of chatter and a lot of people asking serious questions about, and especially, you know, coming from the Afrikaans community, in South Africa, a lot of these guys have an issue with spanking a lady because it feels abusive. That's not how they were raised. So how do you prepare yourself mentally? So your spouse comes to you now and says to you, hey, hubby, I want my bum glistening and sparkling. Can you give me a little bit of a spanking there and make my bum sparkle? How do we prepare ourselves physically and mentally as a top and a bottom going into spanking?
I was going to just interrupt and say, I think there's so many more women now who are really keen to give it a try.
So true. That's so true.
And I just think they don't. Sometimes you're a bit nervous to ask for what you actually want to try or just to experiment. So I always find like a sexy book. Or maybe, you know, when you're in the bedroom, maybe guide the hand and get them to spank you on the bottom and say, oh, that's really nice, and a really positive inflection about that. And also communicate and say, you know, why don't we give it a try? It might just spice up our life. Just kidding.
I think impact comes across as there are a lot of biases related to impact. So there's a lot of things that we believe in life are good or bad. So, you know, pain is associated with something that we are taught to believe is bad. But a lot of people need pain for a release. A lot of people find sexual stimulation from pain alone. They don't need other stimulation. So it's very connected. Pain and pleasure are very connected. Mm-hmm. So finding a way to explain that to your partner. Then I found with a lot of the spanking workshops that we do, I have a lot of guys phone me the next morning in tears because they've woken up and their girlfriend's got a bruise on her bum and they feel horrible for doing that. Mm-hmm. But you have to understand that that was something, and this is what differentiates BDSM from abuse for me. This is something that I ask for. I'm going to ask Mother Russia to panel my ass tonight. Like, I really
panel wanted sounds so sexy, though. Why does Jesus that sound so hot?
I wanted to paddle. I wanted to slap my thighs. Like, I really want red marks all over my thighs. This is my request. So when you understand that this is my request, this is something that I truly get off on. This is something that I truly enjoy. This is something that truly makes me happy. Then you understand it's something that I actually need in my life for release. So I'm asking her for that. I'm giving her my consent to do it. We've had a discussion about what paddles. The listeners can't see, but at the moment on the bed, I probably have 10 paddles, 8 floggers, a hairbrush, a riding crop, a pair of sexy leather gloves, and then a blood paddle, which we won't make blood from tonight, but we just brought along.
Well, if you want to, you can take a photo of that, send it to me quickly, and I'll post the, I'll actually share the impact items on the I'm losing my train of thought. You see, I'm just going into subspace with you already, and I'm not even the one being spanked.
Well, so, on the it's on there. Kinky Bunny should be able to see it on the WhatsApp group.
Okay, brilliant.
So I posted it on there. So I think when it's all about intent, it's the same as how we differentiate something that we do to ourselves from self pleasure to self harm. It's a fine line, but it's how you show up and what intent you are showing up with. And I'm coming to Mother Russia tonight. I have all my facility about me. I have complete capacity. My numbers are an 8 and an 8. I checked in with her this morning already at freaking 5:30 because I was so fucking excited that I was like, get out of bed, bitch. Today. Wake up. You need to go to the beach and have a walk. It's spanking day. Get out of bed. So I checked in with her, much to her disappointment, at 5:30 this morning to tell her I'm ready for spanking day. She's checked in with me. I checked in that she's got capacity for tonight. We've already had that negotiation. Then we've negotiated what's on the table, what we want to use, and we've set a maximum for tonight. We haven't set the minimum, we've set a maximum. So we don't have to break this, not an Olympic record. I don't get a prize for breaking this maximum. So when we reach that, we're going to stop. So we have a time limit for tonight. The time limit is 30 minutes. So that is our maximum. We're not going over that. We know what paddles we're using. We're not adding anything new to the mix. And we've played together quite a bit, just thanks me often. It's very good. And we have an understanding already of what we're going to use. If this was a new relationship, and this was my boyfriend and I didn't know him and he didn't know that I was a crazy psychotic dominatrix, and I was sort of lulling him into a false sense of security, I would do this very gently. I would take out one toy. I would play with the toy. I would use the toy as a sensual toy first. I would rub it all up and down his body. I'd turn him, lay him down on the bed, rub it all the way up and down his body, and then gently paddle his cheeks, just very gently, very lightly, very softly, until he got used to the idea, and then ask him to do the same to me. We only have to start on a 1. We never have to start on a 10. You don't have to pick up baseball bat and hit the shit out of your partner. That's not the plan. The plan is that each paddle has a different feeling. Each paddle has a different texture. Each paddle has a different response in your own body's biochemistry when it hits you. So play around with everything. I mean, what you're seeing in that photograph is a collection of toys over the last 5 years. And these are Mother Russia's toys. These aren't my particular toys because I'm in the middle of moving, so I'm not entirely sure where my toy bag is at this point. So because these toys are super new to me, you'll see tonight Mother Russia's not going to go past a 7 or an 8 on an impact scale. And she's going to start everything on a 3 with me. There's no rush. And my 3 might be different from somebody else's 3. So it's literally about making it fun, because kink is super fun. Have fun with the toy, bring out one at a time.
Fun and exciting. Fun and exciting.
So okay, you said you're starting on a 3. What does that mean though? Because I mean, how would you know what your 3 is? How do we explain to our listeners that my 3 is not necessarily going to be your 3, right? Because I'm going to be a wuss. I'm not as into impact. Well, I like a good impact, but
any instrument that you pick up, I mean, the first thing is you give it to them, you let them hold it, let them slap their hand with it, do your thigh, you know, put it on your thigh. And then just gently pat. You don't just start very slowly and just pat. That's all you have to do.
Okay, here we go. I've just sent that thing on the Podbean app. There we go. So that now listeners can see what we're going to be working with. So I'm really excited to see the one with a heart. It looks like it's got Legos on. Does it have Legos on? Yes, that one. Yes, does it have Legos on? That's so cool. So does that mean you're going to have like a, that one's sexy too. So does that mean that you're going to get to have a heart on your ass?
Yes.
For Valentine's Day, this is fucking epic. I'm sorry, but this is epic. Yeah, I love it.
We also played a game that the person wherever you hit them on the butt, you have to try and get one of the Lego pieces to fly off the bat.
Oh, Jesus. Okay. And is that a unicorn kind? You know, caning is my death, have I told you? Yes, I'm a cane girl, so possibly a little bit more kinky than people thought I would be. Oh, that's so sexy. I absolutely love this. Okay. Is that a table tennis paddle? Somebody asked. Oh, it's Miss Carmen Ellie is asking, is that a table tennis paddle?
This is my favorite toy, and I use it wherever I go. Mm. And it's fantastic for beginners or people who want to experiment because it's not vicious.
Mm.
It's padded, and it gives you a lovely thumping on your ass.
Mm.
It makes it beautiful and warm.
I mean, this ass is going to be glowing tonight. I'm reading up in the chat, and I saw earlier Domina Faye is here. Hello, Domina Faye. It's so nice to see you. Domina Faye says she's got her cane that hangs behind her her door of her room. That's my kind of girl, I'm telling you. We all know I love Domina Faye. Anyway, moving on.
Lolly, there's a whole bunch of different paddles here. So the ping pong bat is really good because it's easy to hold. It's really easy to adjust the swing with it. It's something a lot of people have picked up before, so it's not a strange feeling in their hand. So it's quite a nice beginner's tool. Also, you can't hit that hard with it. So it doesn't matter, even if Mother Russia swings a 10 out of 10 at my ass, it's probably going to land a 6 out of 10 maximum. It just doesn't have the power behind it. It doesn't have the weight behind it to do any damage.
Okay.
Because it's padded with a bit of sponge, there's no chance of it breaking my skin. There's mm-hmm. no chance of it leaving a welt or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's pretty safe as a beginner's paddle, and it's actually a really nice feeling. So I like it for warm-up. I like to be smacked with a ping pong bat for warm-up, also because it makes Mother Russia work a bit hard. I like to see her sweat while I'm sweating. Like, oh. I think that's important.
Can I ask, what is the brush for?
Ah, that's my secret sauce.
Mm, secret. Oh, I love a spicy secret sauce. That makes me happy.
About doing a spanking on someone, you're creating a connection between the two of you. So I find, especially if it's someone that I don't know and I'm just getting to know them, I'm just introducing my body and the feel of my hands and the weight of me. So I use my brush to brush them down like a pony, and then I use my gloved hand to just stroke and caress their body so they get used to the touch of my hand.
Mm, that's hot.
And love. You're waking up the skin.
Yeah,
you want to wake up that skin. You want the skin to be responsive. You want the person's brain to go to their ass and the back of their thighs. So just using that brush and tickling the back of their bum or the back of their thighs just reminds them that those things exist and that they're there. And just gets those things craving a little bit more and just being awake to sensation. So Mother Russia will stroke me with the brush and then stroke me with her hand, and you'll see my bum will start to wiggle, and my body will start to respond on its own. It's super sexy. And then, like, the sharp sting of the ping pong bat will interrupt the brush or the glove rub, and it'll be a different sensation. So impact doesn't have to be about 55 bruises and the change in skin color. Impact can completely be about gentle sensations and just experimenting with this beautiful canvas that we have called the skin.
Mm-hmm.
And the skin covers the whole body. If we wake it up in different ways, if we get the nerves to respond, you're starting a whole different biochemical reaction inside you, and you're literally getting high off the moment. And you don't need to have intense anything to do that. You just a little bit of kindness, a little bit of different sensations will provide a whole lot of pleasure.
I mean, I'm already slipping off my chair. Yeah. This is exciting,
like,
for me.
Like a slow burn of a candle, you know, where you want to have that hot, you know, warm bum feeling that's going to give your chemistry going. But you've got to open up all the pores and all the vessels and the blood vessels and get them knowing that you're there.
Mm-hmm. So Mother Russia, I see here on the bed as well, we've got, it looks like a long wooden bat with a bunch of cartoons on it. Yes. And those cartoons look fucking horrifying. What is that?
This is called the sting. Aptly known, because it's very, very stingy.
Okay.
But obviously once you've used your hand a bit and you've warmed up the bone, and you're getting that nice warm rosy feelings on the ass, then you have the sting, which just wakes up every single nerve ending in your fanny. Just do a little demonstration.
Listen, when Ms Kitten goes, you must know, we're in for a fucking thing. Like, this is going to be a good time. Goodness gracious.
Feeling. It's amazing. It's fantastic.
I mean, how thick is that piece of wood also, though? Because it's quite thick. I'm looking at it and it's quite thick.
It's about 6 mils.
It's about how many mils?
6.
Jeez Louise. Guys, if you have just joined us, we are on air this evening. Ms Kitten and I are doing some live spanking. She's spanking her boob while I'm talking to you guys. I mean, this is going to be a great time. Ms Kitten and I are live this evening with the wonderful Ms Russia from the Playbox. We are going to be doing a live spanking, and Ms Russia is going to spank Ms Kitten's bum on air this evening on Kinky Classes. Yes, guys, you heard it the year first, I'm saying. Before we go to break, let's hear quickly. So we've heard that we know now that a lot of people are getting more into impact. And we've spoken about pre-care or self-care and aftercare. We've spoken about negotiations. We've spoken about consent. We've done all of these things in Kinky Classes. Now we're getting to the lacquer stuff, right? Yeah, now we're getting to the spanks, and we're getting to the ropes, and we're getting to all of these things later in the season. But specifically for Impact 101, what would you say is the first and most important rule of impact play?
First, you need to ask them specific questions. You want to know if they've had anything to drink, if they've eaten, if they've taken any drugs, and if they are willing to let you touch them.
I like that. Ms. Keaton, are you willing to let Ms. Mother Russia touch you?
Hell yes.
Let's get explicit consent on air this evening. We don't want any liabilities afterwards. Lola Blackie Productions does not take responsibility for any actions happening on air this evening. This has been fully consented by Ms. Kitten.
Ms. Kitten has had no substances today. I even stopped drinking coffee at 12 o'clock. I've had 2 liters of water. I have had my dinner like a good kitten. I have had all the spanking stuff laid out since about 1:30 in the afternoon, just in case Mother Russia got happier earlier and wanted to start earlier. I have had absolutely no drugs, not even a painkiller or anything like that in my system. I had a good run this morning. My capacity is good. So I've done a check-in with Mother Russia to make sure that I've had no substances. I've done a check-in to tell her the last time I ate. I've done a capacity check-in at 8 this morning. I'm probably about 9.5 now because I'm so excited. The next question she's going to ask me is, do I have any experience with impact as a giver or receiver? I'm going to give it my cheeky answer and go, no, this is my first time.
This is my very first time.
And she's going to tell me I'm lying.
You're such a liar.
See, really, this is like a practice thing between us. Then she's going to ask me where I want to be spanked, and I'm going to tell her on my sexy ass, on the back of my thighs, and she's going to ask me...
Have we used these implements before?
And I'm going to say, yes, we've used these implements before. Then she's going to ask me...
Is there any activity likely to be triggering, and if there's a plan of action about it, what must we do?
Okay, so if I do get triggered, the Russian knows that she just needs to leave me alone for 5 minutes, and I just need some quiet time, and I'll call her when I'm ready to continue. But this should not likely to be triggering. It's nothing that we haven't done before, and we have a plan of action if it is.
And are there any body parts that I shouldn't touch?
I don't want her to touch my vagina.
The
vagina. I want her to leave my vagina unspanked.
And what about the back of your feet?
I like my feet being spanked, so I'm up for that.
Are we spanking some boobs?
There has been a situation before when I was spanking someone, and I just took my nails and scratched the back of their back, and that just triggered them instantly.
Really?
And I got a fright. Yeah, that was a fright. Okay, then communication.
Yeah, then we're going to discuss communication quickly. Mother Russia will ask me the questions. I'll answer them quickly for you guys so you can hear how we sort that out.
Great.
I used to scale during play of 1 to 10 to gauge intensity. Are you happy with that?
I'm happy with that. So like we said before, everybody's 1 to 10 is different. So 1 for me might be a 10 for Lola. So it's important to start very softly and work from the bottom up every time with every new player and on every new day to check your scale, because things can make a difference to your pain scale. You can be on your period. You could have had a really shit day. There can be a lot of varying factors in how you handle pain. Your emotional state also has a lot to do with that. So it's just important to check your gauge. Every time she picks up a new implement, she'll check the gauge with me and she'll say, what number is this on the first hit? Mm-hmm. And I'll give her a number from 1 to 10.
I'll go, is this a 1 or is it a 2? I'm hitting a 7. I'm already too high. And then I'll just know to back down or to carry on at the same pace that I'm going. Mm-hmm. Then I'm going to say verbal communication. You can use double hand squeezes or double tap out if you're not happy.
So what you're talking about there, Lulz, is verbal communication. I go green.
We use green a lot.
Yeah, and I'm really good at verbal communication. You'd never guess, would you? I don't talk a lot, do I?
I'm reserving my right to answer that one.
But if you get somebody who's not good at verbal communication, or verbal communication is different, or you have them gagged, you know, there could be a lot of reasons why people don't talk to you. Then a hand signal, like a thumbs up, thumbs down, or tap out. If you've had enough, you could use those verbal communications to get out of the situation as well. But you always have your voice, unless you don't.
So some people don't want to say I'm a 1 or a 2 or that's too hard. They want to just experience it and go with the flow. So they prefer just to touch your arm or go finger up and go carry on, go higher, go down.
Mm. Or like we do in Cape Town, put your finger in the air and go purple. I'm bored, move on.
I just want to say Ms Kitten might do that with me on air from time to time. She puts her purple finger up and she goes, I'm bored. Like, let's move on to the next question. Anyway.
I don't have to tell this to Ms Kitten, because this is, how do you show enthusiasm? Giggle, screams, gasp, or internal?
Yeah, so this is also really important. Like, especially for me, when I love pain, so I laugh hysterically when I get hit. So that can be really insulting to somebody.
Fuck my life, yes. I'm thinking like, oh my gosh, some of the doms that I know would get really offended if you had to laugh at them.
I laugh. So it's important to align with your play partner beforehand and say to them, like, I'm going to giggle hysterically. I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing because that's what pain makes me do. So I'm not laughing at you. But some people don't understand that. And if the player is going to be offended by that, if that's going to trigger him, then it's probably not a good mix, because the harder he hits me, the more I'm going to laugh. The harder he hits me because I'm laughing, the more I'm going to laugh at him. He's going to feel very offended by the end of the session and nobody's going to have a good time. I'm going to have a great time, by the way. So,
I mean, hold on. Can I just, I need to know, I need to ask this. Do you identify as a slight bit of brat? Because I'm sensing quite a bit. And also, I want to just mention that I see a lot of switch in you now. I haven't seen it before, but I can see it now, because you've always come across to me very domineering and dominating. But this evening, I'm seeing another part of you that I absolutely adore. You've got this cute little kitten, like, that's just wanting to come out, and she's excited for these bags. But I am sensing a lot of brat with you, Ms Kitten.
I'm playtime.
I don't know about brat. I've always associated myself with being a kitten. Like, I think the title of kitten for me, there's like cats are generally, it doesn't matter how much it's a house cat, there's a bit of feral in every house cat. Mm. I don't think the cat's ever owned. I think the cat owns the house. And the cat there, because the sort of space is provided in the correct manner. That's why the cat stays. There's not much loyalty in cats. Cats are there. Yeah, I think, I don't know if it's breath loss. I don't even know if it's a dominant submissive thing with me. Like, I really love pain. Like, I'm a sadomasochist 100%. Pain super excites me, whether I'm giving it, whether I'm receiving it. The idea of being able to play with pain and tailor pain, because there's so many millions of ways of approaching pain. And pain is this interesting quantity that is different for every single human being. Like, just in the numbers of the smacks, just in the intensity, is different for every single person, and it's going to be different for every person listening to it. Some people are going to be alarmed by it because they're going to be in their own experience. There's a negative bias that's associated with that. Some people are going to be fucking turned on because in their association, there's a positive bias that's associated with that. So pain has this way of bringing out everybody's emotions in a room, even though it's only happening to one person. And it just fucking excites me, and I love it.
I'm excited for you. Okay, and on that note, listeners, we need to go to a slight commercial break. When we come back, guys, you do not want to miss this, right? Trust me, you do not want to miss this. So I expect to see all the live listeners, and I'm looking at that bum at the moment. Jeez Louise, hold on to your hair, because that's a hot ass. Holy shitness. Okay, I'll negotiate whether we can share a photo of Ms. Kitten's bum on the Podbean app this evening with everybody so that we can see the canvas that we are working with this evening. But before further ado, let's go to a slight commercial break. When we come back, guys, live Spanks on this evening's episode of Kinky Classes with Lola and Ms. Kitten. Don't go anywhere. Go refill your water, because we don't kink and drink. See you later. Ms. Kitten, you need to mute.
Sometimes we're looking for the more, but we just don't know what the more is. And then we come to play with me. Three words that mean play, toys, fun, games, cheekiness, with, intimacy, connection, relationships, and finally me. It starts with self, and that is something that Play With Me stands for. Play With Me is a place where you have an experience of all of those things. One complete cycle. You're welcome to pop in at our shop at the Gantry in Four Ways, or find us at www.playwithme.co.za. If you're looking for that more, please get in touch.
I know that wasn't quite 10 minutes, right? But I'm looking at this video call going, they're already warming that butt up for a good spanking. Good evening, listeners, and welcome to class number 5 of Kinky Classes in this semester, this first semester of Kinky Classes. You guys are live this evening. It's Lola, Ms Kitten, and Ms Kitten is going to get her bum spanked. She's about to get her bum spanked because we are doing Spanks and Sparkles. Yes, I'm sorry, I'm still a little bit sick. Well, not a little bit sick, I'm fucking sick. But we're doing this thing because I'm excited. I'm watching this video call with her that I've got with Ms Kitten because they are phoning us. They're phoning in by Cape Town this evening, and she's getting her bum brushed and scratched by Mother Russia's nails, and she's wiggling her bum. She's loving this already. This is exciting. We're having a hell of a time this evening. We're doing Spanks and Sparkles, Impact 101. Before the commercial break, we discussed about having capacity, about being able to say to the person that's going to top you or going to be giving your spanks to, where you are, what do you feel like? Have you eaten today? Have you had some water to drink, like Domina Faye loves to say? Have you had any drugs? Both of them have said they haven't. Both of them have eaten. Both of them have had something to drink. They both had very high capacity. Ms Kitten was going, she was possibly a 9.5 because she was excited for this evening spanks. So we've really gone through the whole negotiation process, and the previous episodes, everything has been leading up to this. Right? Happy Valentine's Day. Happy Singles Awareness Day. And I mean, why is my phone not charging? This is a problem. Hold on. Let's figure this one out quickly. There we go. Okay, it's charging now. So everybody is at full capacity and we are ready to get this started. Ms. Kitten, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling with my hands, Lola.
You see, you are a cheeky little brat. I knew it.
I see the
there's two questions that are in the chat that I just want to answer quickly before I can't answer them anymore. What is warm up, and is it necessary for all types of impact play? So it's not. You can, when you put your hand on your bum now, everybody put your hand on your bum. Mm. Your bum should be cold to touch.
My bum's hot because I've been sitting on it.
Yeah, that's just weird, and you're sick. But normal people don't have a raging fever and are not suffering from COVID. So your bum will be warm, like a body temperature warm. It's not going to be freezing cold, but your skin will feel, your skin won't feel hot to touch. Your skin also won't feel hard if you press down on it. So we call that a cold bum. We call that completely unprepared. So as you start, as Mother Ash is starting to warm my bum's starting to get a little bit more rosy. And the blood's starting to flow to the surface. And if you start to touch it in between the spanks, you'll feel that it's getting warmer. So my body's reaction is creating heat. So there are certain types of impact, like a caning, where you don't want a warm bum. You want to be able to see the strut directly on the bum. So you wouldn't need to warm up. But when you're starting for what we've chosen tonight with the paddles, a warm-up's nice. Like, and this isn't the Olympics for me. I don't want to be marked horribly tomorrow. I want to have a good spanking that's sensual and that's a little bit stingy, and that's pushing my boundaries slightly, but that's not really very challenging. This is about pleasure for me tonight. This is not about an intense meeting. So it depends on what you want. So some items, like blood play items, need to be done on a hot bum. So a bum that's been warmed up really, really well, where there's a lot of blood at the surface. Some items need to be done on a cold bum where there's absolutely nothing. So it just depends on what item you're using, what the intention of the play is, and what your negotiations include. But I quite like the bum rubs. I quite like the gentle pats. Like, this is all fun for me. So it also makes Mother Russia work quite hard, which enjoys. So I'm gonna let it.
Mother Russia loves it.
So I'm gonna let Mother Russia keep spanking me and keep rubbing my bum, which she's doing at the moment. It's really pleasant. Until with sort of all the blood's at the surface and I'm ready to take a slightly harder paddle just now.
Mm. So tell me, I mean, I'm watching you and I'm hearing the spanking that you're already getting, the like warm up spanking that you're already getting, and you are able to talk like properly. You haven't nudged or nudged once.
The leather glove's got padding in it. It's quite nice and soft. My pain threshold's really high, lols. So this for me is probably a 3 out of 10. So let's ask her to go a bit harder so you can hear it.
Okay.
Okay, that's about a 4. It's now slightly stingy. And she's taking the glove off. That's cheating. Actually not cheating, because it hurts her hand more than it hurts my bum at this point. So she's now cupping. She's doing my thighs. But she's still rubbing in between. Very nice.
So at what point, Ms. Kitten, do you presume, would you go into, okay, this is still very, very early days, right? But at which point would you presume, would you go into subspace?
Oh, you got about, Mother Ashley's got about an hour and a half before she gets me into subspace.
Oh, really?
No. Okay, so there's two things. My attention is on the podcast tonight. So I'm not allowing my body to completely absorb what's happening behind me. As much as I'm enjoying it, I'm not totally focused on the spanking. I'm still a little bit more focused on the podcast. So this for me wouldn't be a subspace thing for a while. I'd need to be more focused on what was happening on my ass. I wouldn't give Mother Russia the pleasure immediately. I'd make her work for at least an hour. She's taking the glove off now. She's now spanking me with her hand. It's getting a bit harder. So I'd say it's about a 6 out of 10 now. It's feeling quite nice, much more stingy. So you've got two types of impact pain that it can either be a thuddy, heavy feeling, or it can be quite sharp and stingy. So if you smack yourself on your thigh with your bare hand, it's quite a stingy feeling. That's the type of pain I prefer. I don't like that. Like a cane pain is a stingy pain.
Yes, that's what I love.
Deep bone, that bone hitting pain from a heavy paddle.
That's mm-hmm. not for me.
I'm also not a fan. I'm in alignment with you. 100% with you in alignment. Like I said, I'm a cane rider. Anyway, yeah. Okay, so after the Spanks with a hand, what are we moving on to? What is your first implement that you have chosen this evening?
The ping pong mat. Actually, I think she's going to, just so that you guys can hear it, it's not something that I enjoy particularly, but she was going to just swing the flogger a little bit so the guests and the listeners okay. could hear the flogger.
I'm going to for everybody that just joined us, I'm going to go ahead and share again the two photos that I shared earlier. There is the implements that we are using this evening on Miss Kitten's bum. And then I'm going to be naughty and share another photo of her bum so that you guys can see the good bum that we're working with this evening. It is a good ass.
Oh! This is a flogger.
So we're watching this flogger now, right? It's black, and it's quite intense.
It's a weird feeling because there's like a rush of air between my legs when it comes at me. It's quite a strange feeling. It's quite spicy. It's quite stingy on the ends, and she's moving it quite quickly on my ass. I'd give it a 5 out of 10 from an intensity point of view. I didn't quite expect it to be. And every now and again, it does hit my vagina, and it's a little bit stingy and sharp. It's quite nice though when it does.
I mean, you're shaking vagina on Lola. I wanted to say Lola's lessons. You see, I'm going like, I'm just sitting here drilling. We're hitting vaginas this evening on Kinky Klasses. This is the best time.
I'm not going to lie. It's a new sensation for me. I don't normally get flogged, but I'm not hating it. My brain is saying yes. My thighs are saying hell yes. My thighs really like it. And my vagina is saying not bad. This could continue.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's quite nice.
Let's try the
thinner
leather.
I mean, what is the weight of the flogger?
The weight, the flogger's really thick and heavy, Lols. It's made of really good leather, mm-hmm. and it weighs quite a lot. So it's really thick and heavy. It's more thuddy than I'd normally like. We've gone to the second flogger, which is the black flogger. It's slightly more thingy. It's not as nice as the grey one, actually. Maybe Mother Russia must just spice it up a bit. Let's go a bit harder. Ow!
Jeez Louise, I'm sitting in shock. Guys, if you have just joined us, we are doing live spankings this evening on air. So if you guys hear us giggle, it's because we're having a good time, right? This is fucking amazing. I'm watching as they get the giggle, as they get the spanking. And like Miss Kitten has no scum, okay? She's wiggling her bum. She's like, yes, this is what I want. I'm loving this. And Mother Russia is just rubbing away at it. This is really, really, really. Black Dragon, yes, she actually said, please rub my bum. What is the next implement? The next implement, oh, we're going to the cane. Yes, baby. Lola, get ready to slip and slide off your chair now.
We're going to see if we can leave a unicorn on my bum.
Oh, hold on. I need to, our load shedding just went off, so I need to put my fan off. Hold on.
Wait. Lola's coming back. I think the other question is, which areas of the body should be avoided and which impact implements should be used on certain areas? Avoiding anything that's got bone, I wouldn't go directly for the bone, and anything that's got nerve endings in it. So any, the bend of the knee, directly underneath the line of the buttocks.
The coccyx area.
Yeah, anything with bone, the coccyx spine. Area, spine. You want to go for nice fleshy areas. So like
plump areas.
Yeah, your butt cheeks, your beautiful bum cheeks, the back of your thighs, the inside of your thighs. There's also good spots. Those are some right there.
Look, they are, I don't have a copy of it now, otherwise I could have shared it with the listeners, but they are red zones.
We'll share it and...
There are red zones that we don't really want to. Okay, we can't hear the impact that well. Hold on, let Lola keep quiet.
Okay, ready.
I'm
Okay, again, that wasn't. Okay, that's about a 6. You can go to an 8.
Okay. Or
oh,
the same thing?
Yeah. Okay.
Rabbit giggle. I commend Ms Kitten this evening for getting the spanking on behalf of science. We're doing this for science. This is good. I mean, we're having a great time. So now Ms. Russia, Mother Russia, has put the cane down and she is just smacking really, really rough with her hand.
She's just warming it up again. So she's just warming up all the skin. She's just evening out the skin. And I'm just using it as an excuse so I can get more bum rubs.
You like the bum rubs, don't you?
I love the bum rubs. They're the best part.
For science. We're doing this for science, guys. Hashtag for science. Go and like, just follow hashtag for science. Okay, has the crop left a mark yet? That's what we want to know.
Has the crop left a mark? Mother Russia, is there a mark?
Jesus, I just see a very red bum. Wow, it really looks good though. It is really sparkly. That's a glowing one.
Can you hear this?
I can.
Can you hear that?
So this is now the table tennis, paddle thingy.
Ping pong bat.
The ping pong bat, there we go.
Okay, wait, they want a picture, Jen. Hold on.
Do you want a picture quick?
We're just taking a photo. While we're taking a photo of the red bum, the red sparkly bum, the red sparkly bum, Lola will talk you through what we're doing at the moment. So we have a bunch of implements this evening. It is Spanks and Sparkles on Kinky Klasses. Ms Kitten has given us her bum for science this evening so that we can do an impact play live on air. We love her very much for that. Ms Kitten, how are you feeling? Where are you capacity wise?
I know, I'm fabulous. I'm like a 10 out of 10 at the moment.
Is it? Green?
I'm green. Very green. Green, 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 green.
What am I level wise?
You're at about a 6.
Okay, 6.
Yeah, it's not hard.
Not too bad.
No, it's good. You can go a little bit harder. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. So that ping pong bat's lovely. Can you hear the big sound it makes?
Yes, I can. It sounds very much shuddery, though.
It's not at all. Because it's so light in her hand, because the rubber protects it, it's very smooth on the skin. So it's probably half as stingy as her hand, but it makes such a lovely noise. And it provides a lot of heat without a lot of pain. So Mother Rush is working a lot harder than I am at the moment.
I just want to know, do you guys have neighbors? Are there neighbors?
Yeah, they are, but not close enough to be.
Okay, because I'm thinking, like, if I was a neighbor, I would have been slapping off my chair listening to this. Mother Rasha, what are you experiencing as the top?
I'm loving it because she's moving her bum around. She's giving me lots of cues that she's enjoying it. So I'm just watching her body language and how she's moving her shoulders and her bum, so I know she's happy. So I'm just checking in to see if I can go harder or softer and moving around. And as soon as I think she's had enough on this paddle, then I move on to the next heavier one.
That's great. Okay, how many implements do we still have left this evening?
Yeah, Lord, you tell us, how many are we allowed to still go through?
Well, we're already on an hour, so let's do another two. So pick another two, your favorite two, and let's do this thing. Are you sharing that photo of your bum with me?
Yeah, I'm on it.
I just saw a nice photo being taken now. So
we just want to say thank you to Aina Fulkitz for a lovely paddle that we bought from him, which is amazing.
Oh, really? Which paddle is that now?
I've got this on now. I'll show you. Looks like this.
Oh, that's the black leather one. That's really pretty. Is that Aina Fokert?
Yeah. Ow! Oh, fuck.
Okay, what is that at?
That's a 9.
Oh, really? A 9 for Ms Kitten is probably going to be like 100 for Lola. This is, yeah, it lives up to its name, says Athos, Cape Town. A 9, okay, so we just had a 9 on the pain scale. This is quite good.
That's quite the paddle. It's, okay, Miss Mother Rush is quietened. It's nicer on my thighs. She's quietened down it. It's better on the thighs. Your hips stingy on my bum.
Really? Well, your bum's been getting quite a good spanking.
Rub.
I'm so surprised. This is... Guys, for everybody that have just joined us, I promise we aren't high. We aren't laughing because it's funny. Okay, we're laughing because this is really a good time. We are doing Spanks and Sparkles Impact 101 this evening on Kinky Klasses, and we are having a great time. It's really... We're moving on to another vlogger, a yellow vlogger. Where is this from? Also, Aina Fokert, or is this part of the playbox?
This is a playbox vlogger. It's nice. It's super thingy, but it's not more than a 6. So she's just giving my bum a bit of a break to make sure that I'm not dying.
Okay.
I've forgotten how to use my phone, so I might be slightly more in subspace than I want to admit.
This is perfect. Everybody's asking for pics. Yes, we're trying to get the pics. So she's spacing already. We're trying to get the pics. Just tell me once you've managed. Okay. Oh, we're going to that thick bat. It looks like a bat to me. That's the one. Let me send you guys these. Hold on.
Just take a quick look so we can show them again.
I can't unselect it. Okay, it won't let me unselect it. Anyway, okay, we're trying to take a nice photo for you guys with the next photo that we're going to be sharing. It's just taking a while to load. I don't exactly know why.
So this is called the sting bat. This is like discipline. Oh, this is like discipline, like real discipline. Oh, oh. She's hitting me now. That's about a 4 out of 10. Ah, fuck. That was about a 6. It's quite so. Ow.
Like how she goes. Ow. Ooh. Okay. I'm getting photos, yeah. Let me save them. Ms. Kitten, while I save them and send them, you're going to have to talk the listeners through what you're feeling. And let's hear from Ms. Russia what she's feeling as well.
Okay, so it's the thin bat's really quite stingy. It's like being hit with a ruler almost, but the wood's quite thick, so it's got a bit of weight behind it. So, it's never a soft one. I love it on the thighs. And
nice sharp slap with a sting on your bum. And yeah. It goes all the way across because it's a nice long bat.
Yeah, so she can do both legs at the same time.
At the same time.
Escaping it. Like it's like total torture, but good torture.
But the nice thing is she's nice and warmed up on the bum, and the bum is beautifully rosy and red now. So I can go a bit harder because she can take more. The warmer she is, the harder I can go.
So okay, we are on the bat implement now. Let Lola keep quiet so that we can hear the bat work, right?
Sorry, Lola, I missed that completely. You're going to have to repeat that question. My brain was somewhere else.
Ah! Lola does sound better, right? It's definitely from the excitement.
Okay, she's doing bastinado on my feet at the moment.
Okay.
So, the listeners were asking if there's anywhere that you shouldn't hit. So places like your feet have a lot of different nerve endings, and what, if you don't know what you're doing, you should avoid that completely. Mm. When you start spanking, just start with your hand and make sure that you get to know your partner's body first before you pick up an item and hit them with it on some strange part of their body. I think that, you know, just getting to know that your partner with your own body first and then adding implements is probably the best way to suggest start to spanking without going for a lesson. Mm-hmm. But, you know, what always amazes me is we have so many amazing professionals in this community and people don't use them enough. So, you know, going to mistress with your partner is a super fun experience because that mistress can then help you learn to spank your partner properly.
Mm.
I would have empathy with me. She's now got the glove back on and she's rubbing my bum. It's very nice.
I went and disconnected myself there for a minute. So I'm back. Yes, the bum that we are working with this evening. And let's do another one. It must be a lot of excitement, Domino Faye, in Joburg this evening. This is the leather paddle that Anna Fockett has provided for this specific episode, for this specific 101. And I can't even talk, guys. I think I'm going into space on behalf of you guys. This is a lot of fun. Then we've got the bat that we were just talking about. And okay, so Domino Faye also says she's happy to offer couple sessions on discount for Kinky Classes, and that's why we absolutely love Domino Faye. Domino Faye was a guest. She's been a guest on Kinky Classes twice. She's also been a guest on Lola's Lessons. She's an absolute goddess. So if any of the couples that want to do some impact play, get into contact with Lola. Lola will send you into contact with Domino Faye, and then we can get you guys some discounts. Thank you for that, Domino Faye. We really, really appreciate that.
We'll do the same thing from Playbox in Cape Town. So if there's any Cape Town couples that are looking for a partner workshop, we're quite happy to facilitate an hour and let you play with our toy boxes and let you guys have some fun and guide you a little bit. So we're also super happy to facilitate from our side. So if they get in touch with you, you can support Joburg and Cape Town like that.
That's brilliant. Thank you so much. We really appreciate that. That is absolutely amazing. I see Domino Faye, while I was on air now, has also sent me the impact chart. Thank you very much for that. So luckily, Lola can multitask, yes. So Lola's quickly going to just save that. While I save that and get that shared, Ms. Kitten, is there anything that you want to relate to the listeners before we end this evening's episode?
Yeah, just that. Always keep this fun, guys. The whole idea of being kinky is to have to have fun and to enjoy the time you spend with your partner and to be honest and give them honest feedback. And you've heard me scream and shout a bit tonight. Mother Russia knows what that sounds like when it's not happy screaming, and she knows what it sounds like when I'm not enjoying the situation. She's really good at reading my body language. She's able to play around a bit. She's able to mess around with me because we have a relationship that's been forged over a good couple of years. So, you know, don't expect everything to go this way in the beginning, and you don't need a whole lot of fancy toys to start. You literally need your hand and your partner, and there's enormous pleasure to be provided with that. And just get to know each other. It's not the Olympics. Start small. And if you are careful, you can choose things that don't leave marks. So the ping pong bat is a great way to go because of that padding. It won't bruise the top layer of the skin. You can't hit too hard. You can't do any serious damage to your partner. Even if you hit in the wrong place, you're not going to injure them terribly. So choose stuff that's easy to work with, that you can trust the implement. Once you've learned to trust the implement, once you've got control over the implement, then you can go for bigger and harder. I mean, we've got stuff on the table here tonight that I don't even use very often. We've got something called the Pope, which is a hell of a bat, and it's super heavy. And we've got, what is this one?
The Harvey Dent.
We've got something called the Harvey Dent, which has got like rope on the one side and it's smooth on the other side.
This is a mother.
I saw that one. You showed that one to me on the video chat. So that one looks like a mother.
One of each. Okay, go. I'm ready.
Okay, but only a seven, not harder than a seven.
Okay, that wasn't too bad. Go eight. Okay, go nine. Ah, oh, fuck. Jesus. Oh, fuck.
Yes. Okay, which one was that now?
That's the Harvey Dent.
I'll show you in the video.
Okay. Oh, yes, that one looks fucking like awfully sore. I wouldn't. I'm sorry. I love you, Ms. Kitten, for doing this for Spank, for like doing the Spanks for science. We love it. We love you. Thank you for doing this. This is amazing.
So you don't need the heavy stuff, like there's a time and a place for all of it, like you know, something very interesting that we've been discussing a lot in the classes that I've been doing recently is we always think about making the bum go pink, but what happens when your skin isn't pink and can't go pink? What reactions are you looking for then? So what I would suggest you do, like a very cool way to start spanking, is to blindfold each other. And then to be close enough that you've got your partner over your lap and that you're spanking and you're rubbing and you're feeling the skin and you're feeling the skin's reaction to the impact. And you'll feel the little raised bumps. You'll feel the skin getting hot. You'll feel the skin getting harder underneath your touch. When you can feel all of that, then you're ready to go to the next level. And it's not about changing the color of the bum. It really isn't. It's about providing pleasure for each other and providing sensation for each other. So this doesn't have to be a session that you're leaving marks unless you want them. Some of us are really dedicated to our marks. I get that. I can be one of those human beings. But, you know, I have to adult the next day. So tomorrow I have to go and walk around and sit and do all those things that normal adults have to do. So I can't afford to do it, but I still want to have the fun. So tonight's session, I won't leave a mark on my bum. We've had an enormous amount of fun. We're going to go and then we're going to keep spanking for about another hour still. you guys are going to be boring people on a Wednesday night because I've been waiting all day for this. It doesn't have to be about leaving a trace. It just has to be about the moment and enjoying it with your partner. And you can do that in a safe way. The gloves pad the hands, so there's very little chance of leaving a mark with the gloves. The ping pong paddle is really super padded. The serious stuff, the stuff that we brought out that's really stingy and bitey, and those are great, but they're not necessary and they're not going to make or break the deal. What's going to make or break the deal is that warm-up, that interaction between the two of you, that readying of the canvas to take the impact. And then the giggles and the tea and the cuddles afterwards are just as important as the actual spanking session and your intent of why you're doing this. I mean, this is honestly what I want, so she's giving me what I want. This is not something I'm doing for her or for any other reason.
And I just ended off by saying tip from Mother Russia is try not to spank in the same position all the time. Try and move your spanks all over the bum so you're getting an even spread of spanking. Because it starts to get monotonous if it's in one time, same position all the time. So even it out, move around, and you don't have to stay in the same position all the time. Move around the bum, you know, move left to right, up and down. And then just get together and enjoy it and have fun. That's what it's all about.
I mean, this evening has been absolutely a ball of fun, right? I have laughed so much. I have gotten my voice back mostly, which is so exciting. It's obviously all the phlegm that goes and lies on the voice box. But that's all thanks to you guys. So I don't even think I need medicine. I just need to watch more spanking of Ms. Kitten's bum. So for science, we thank you.
Can I come and spank you?
You're not going to spank me with a paddle. You're going to start off with a cane and you're going to end off with a cane because that's the only thing I allow. That's the only thing I like. But when it comes to canings, like I can take a proper caning. I'm a cane baby.
Yeah, it's interesting. And Loz, I think we all change. The journey is different. Mm. It doesn't stay the same. 10 years ago, I loved the cane. 20 of the best of the cane was absolutely my thing. Now I'm not that person anymore. I don't want to experience that as much as I want to experience other things. So, you know, that everybody changes, mixing it up, trying new things, be brave. Yeah, fortune favors the brave. And keep your sex life sparkling, guys. Try new things. Bring home a kinky kitchen utensil and let's see if you can spank
your partner. Love that. Yes, yes, yes. Can we have more of that? Can we have more of just bringing something kinky home? I mean, I hope the listeners had a wonderful Valentine's Day. I hope you guys had a little bit of sexy time or planning on having a sexy time this evening after the kinky classes. And I mean, this has been an exciting kinky classes, right? I hope you guys had a great Valentine's Day. This is what it's been all leading up to, right? When Ms. Kitten and I discussed this show last year, we discussed doing it just before Valentine's Day because we wanted to get people excited for this specific show, for doing an impact on Ms. Kitten on air live. This has been the goal right from the start. Really excited. Thank you everybody for listening in. I mean, we've got over 1,200 live listeners. We love you guys to like the ends of the earth. Lola loves a lot of you. Ms. Kitten loves you too. Yes, Ms. Kitten, you do, right?
I do. I love you all and I love you, Lols. And thanks to our amazing mods and our amazing listeners. And we'll see you next week.
And thank you, mods. Thank you, production manager. Thank you to everybody listening. We love the lot of you. Stay safe. Stay kinky. Remember to drink water, eat, and make sure you do your check-ins. We love the lot of you. Take care. Have a good evening.